Okay, so we were studying about the main provisions of a Consumer Protection Act. In that, the second point we were studying, you know, grounds for complaint. So first we studied that there is any unfair or a restrictive trade practices are there. For that, we can file a complaint. Then second one is that if any defective goods, like the goods that we have purchased is not of the quality that we have expected, if any defects are there, a consumer can file a complaint against the defective goods. Defect may relate to the quality, quantity, quality or potency or purity of the product, or the goods are not in accordance with the related act or contract. For instance, in a packet, if the quantity of material is not the same as original written in the packet. So like when we are asking for a product, when we are demanding for a product, or when the sample is shown, so they have shown some very nice sample, very nice products are there, and after that they have changed the product. When they send the real product, then what happens is that they don't send the same, that quality of product is not there. So in such a cases we can file a complaint. Okay, or if the power or potency of a product is less than the standard potency, it is the case of a potency related defect. Potency means the capacity or power of the product. Like imagine that if you are purchasing a product, then they are showing that, or they saw that this much amount of power is there. Imagine that if like a motor, if you are purchasing, it is based on the horsepower, you know. So, or if you are purchasing a car, so then also it is car is like a CC is the power it shows. So if they say that if or different products are there, like if like a 100 CC bike is there, if a 100 CC bike means or 120 CC, 180 CC, 220 CC different power is there for the bike. So it shows that see, like if you use full acceleration and if within this much time, so there is a fixed time is there, like 5 seconds, 10 seconds time, it will reach up to a minimum level of speed. So that is the power of the engine is calculated like that. And also the mileage, you know, so different car and all or different vehicle when we are purchasing, they say that this much is the mileage. So but mileage is calculated like when we are riding on the road, you will not get the mileage that we are expected given. So what they do is that they keep the bike on the stand and they attach a motor on the wheel. So then they put a full acceleration, they put 1 liter of petrol, and they put a like a fourth gear they will put, and a full acceleration if they use, then in 1 liter it will show like 60 kilometer, 70 kilometer, it will work. But that is not the real condition, you know. So like if you are running on the road, if they say that if you have to keep it on the fourth gear full, and it should go in like a 60 kilometer, it means the speed should be like a 60 kilometer, 50 to 60 kilometer range we have to go. If you are putting it on the fourth gear and going in 100 kilometer speed, then this mileage you will not get. Okay, so if you have to maintain this mileage, it should go on fourth gear. It should be a flat area, like there should not be up and downs or a hump or this type of thing should not be there, any disturbance should not be there. So if on the highway if you are going, and if you are going very fast, it is not there. Okay, minimum speed you have to go 60, 50 to 60, 40 to 60 range speed should be there. If we are going like that, then they will we get the mileage. But if you are going like in the gully and all, if you are going there, we need to reduce the gear, then we have to use acceleration here and there. So such kind of things are there. When you use acceleration, like if you are doing, that time more fuel is consumed. And when you are changing the gear, that time also the more fuel is consumed. And when you are traveling in like a first gear, second gear like that, then more fuel is consumed. So, if the quality that we have expected is not received when we are purchasing a product, then we can file a case against the product. That is about the defective goods. Then deficiency of service. Under this act, the consumer concerned can file a complaint against a defective or underrated services. Some examples of deficiencies in services are like unnecessary delay in providing loans by banks. Like bank is a service provider, actually they are providing service to us, and we have applied for a loan, and all the documentation, every work is okay, but also simply they sometimes they will delay the loan, you know. So they will delay the loan, see that there are some targets and all are there. Like in this month, if they are giving loan, then they may have lose their points. So they will hold the, even if all the procedures are completed, but they will hold the loan and they will sanction it in the next month only, because it will come in the next month's account. Do you understand? If the target is achieved, or if they want to achieve the target more, then even if the policy is not, or if the procedures are not completed, they will give it in the current month itself. So, but if there is if any kind of if you have submitted an application, and if we are not getting, after there are still time is required for the processing, so that time is there. But even after that, if they delay, then unnecessary delay in giving final touches to the claims by the insurance companies. Another cases are there. Like imagine that if you are having an insurance, you have taken insurance policy, you are paying insurance premium, and if your car is meeting with an accident, and if you claim for the insurance, they will not give the insurance money suddenly. So they will try to delay it. They will go it for maybe 1 year, 2 years time. It will take some 4-5 years or so, even if there are some cases and all are there, it will take a long time. So if you are meeting with an accident, then we have to go, they will call in the court, they will call sometimes, then we have to go there and present there. And if when we are going, the opponent may not come. Accident took place with two people. Then when they are calling in the court, if they call, then we have to go, and at that time other member also should come. And if both are not coming, then it will take a problem. And if normally all the procedures have completed, then also the insurance companies will delay the loan. So they will delay the insurance premium. They will try maximum to not to give. Because it is a loss for them. So they will delay it so that at last we feel that there is no need, then we will leave and go. Such a way they will delay it. So if there is unnecessary delay like that, it can be there. Unnecessary delay in supplying goods by the transport companies. See, products are there, so we are giving it to the transportation companies. So these transportation companies take these products. Imagine that if we have to transport some goods are to be brought from Kolkata. So it is there in Kolkata, and we have to bring it. And they said 10 days time is given. But it is taking more time, 10, 15 days, 20 days time if it is taken. So such a delay, more delay is there than for that. And wrong billing by electricity and telephone departments, this problem will be there. When we are having, our bills are there, electricity bill will be coming. Sometimes, BSNL, this bill and all was coming, even if you are not using, not making any call also, then also you will get a big bill. Sometimes how much you are using, that much bill may not be there. So some these kind of issues are there. So if any Wi-Fi or mobile or these type of things are there, so at that time, if how much we are paying, how much we are using, that much amount of it should be displayed there. Okay, somewhere our meter and all is there, the electricity meter. Even if you switch on one bulb itself, it will start rotating very fast. Digital meters are there, it will be like that. So these are the deficiency of services. Then excessive charging of price. Consumers can lodge a complaint against excessive charging of price. Excess charges mean overcharging in the following cases, price written on the packet of the product. See, if the charge is, if we imagine that if you, any product, it is compulsory that on a product, the MRP, maximum retail price of a product has to be written there, printed there. But see, imagine that if you are purchasing a Sprite or Coca-Cola, things like that. If 35 rupees is written there, but they will charge 40 rupees. And if you ask why are you charging more, then they will say that cooling, we are using fridge. So it is the duty of the it is their responsibility to store it in the fridge. It is not our responsibility that they are. For that only the company is providing them money. They are not getting it for 35 rupees. They are getting it for 25 or 30 rupees. And the money that they have to charge is supposed to be there. If you demand them, then they will give it on this one. If you say that you ask, if a Sprite bottle is asking, if you ask for 40 rupees, and if you say printed price is 35 only, if you will say, then they will give it for 35. Some shopkeepers will give. Some may say that you don't purchase from here, you can go and purchase from any other place. So if you are demanding, then only. Otherwise, they will allow it. They will take it for granted that 5 rupees extra profit they are taking. It is not, it is the responsibility. If I am selling cold drinks, it is my responsibility to keep purchase fridge and keep it in the fridge. Okay. But most of the time, this type of problems they take. Or price written on the product, or price decided by any act. So sometimes some act and or a ceiling price or a floor price like that, are there, or some kind of products like especially food items and all, they give a kind of like a margin prices set. So sometimes if that price, if anybody is selling above that price, then for that action can be taken. The next one, supply of hazardous goods. If the product which can prove hazardous for life are sold without proper information, their use, content and effects, then the victim concerned can lodge a complaint. Some of the hazardous products are like a pressure cooker, electrical appliances, cooking gas. So like a pressure cooker and all is there. So like if there is like in the pressure cookers, earlier there was problem that people used to die, especially women and all, they die because of the pressure cooker blast. But now there are some like a safety novice, they are attached on the pressure cooker, even if one knob is there, so it will not, the entire pressure cooker will not blast, but that this one is there, that will be blasting. Or if this like a power supply is there, or that MCB one thing is there, you know. So these type of things are used. Electric products are there, in that also they use fuses, are there fuse, you know. So there, if any kind of short circuit or any other problems are there, so this fuse will burn. So then for that it is there. So on the electronic products, it is there that sometimes like an iron box and all, if you purchase on the body, if you touch also, you will get shock. You know, some computer also, I heard earlier one Toshiba laptop was there. And on that, if you touch on the body while charging, if you put for charging and touch on the body, then you will get shock. You know, so such a way it will be there. Sometimes this materials, it is manufactured, that is all, these are all the manufacturing problem. So it was very old one. So that is why maybe some problem may be there. So I had given it for repairing once. Then after that only started, they might have given connection on the body also. So it is there like that. So these are the some of the situations where we can file complaint. So these are the situations. Okay. Then next one, there is a three-tire judicial machinery. The information regarding the three-tire judicial machinery, we have to study about this in detail. Then complaint disposal period. Under this act, there is a provision for complaint, for disposal of complaints expeditionary. In normal situation, the maximum time limit for the period is 3 months. If under some special conditions, there is a need to test the product, then a maximum limit is given like 5 months. So minimum, like this, if you raise a complaint against a problem, then there is a maximum time is there, like it should be of 3 months time. Within 3 months, the decision has to be made. If it is not taken, then there will be action will be taken. Okay. And if in some products and all are there, some testing and all is required, like some lab test and all is required. If you are filing a complaint that if in this product some hazardous things are there, so then they will send it for testing, and some lab test result and all is required. So in such a cases are there, if it is long procedure is required, then in some cases it will be extended up to 5 months time. And who can file a complaint? Okay, so that is there. See, if a consumer, if you are using a product, if you are using, who is a consumer, we have already studied. If I am a consumer, I can file a complaint against this. A registered consumer association. So there are so many registered consumer associations are there. So if I am alone and if I am unable to file a case, then there are so many consumers associations are there. So you can take a membership from the consumers association, and all the people affected will be members of this consumer association, and they will be filing case. One or more consumers. See, like when a group people are there. See, like if one person is there, then power of the complaint is less. But imagine that if you are traveling, all the people are there, then together, if a group of people are there, then the power will be more power will be there. Okay. Then central government and the state government. The government can also file a case against a particular company or a particular product. If any product is found defective or any kind of issues are there, then the central government and the state government also can file case. Then next one, against whom the complaint be filed. So from against whom we have to file the complaint. So for defective products, seller and manufacturer. If a defective product is found, then we can file complaint against the seller or the manufacturer. And if a deficiency of services are there, then a service provider who is giving a service. If a product is found like the seller, but the seller is also responsible. Imagine that you are going to the shop and purchasing. So if the seller is if it is like a overpricing. So this is maybe only of the seller. Manufacturer may not know also that they are selling on this price. Okay. Sometimes if there is a problem with the interior part of the product, so then seller is not responsible. It is a problem with the company. So the manufacturer will be against the manufacturer. We can file complaint. And complaint fee, with every complaint it is fixed fees is deposited, although court fee or any other expenses are not to be paid. So they say like, yeah, if you want to file a complaint, then there is a complaint fees is there. Okay, simply you cannot make a complaint, there is a fees to be paid. So that fees we have to pay. And what are the relief or remedies available to consumers? What are the ways in which we can get the response? So first one is removal of defects. If a product is found defective, then when we file a case, the court will order to the company to remove the defect. If any defective product is there, that defect will be removed and given back. Or replacement of goods. Sometimes like the product which is given, it is having problem, then they will replace the product. Like mobile phone and all, if you are returning the product, then if it is having a problem, then they will give another mobile phone. Same company, same brand, same product will be there, another product, replacement. Then refund of price. Sometimes if the company cannot replace the product, if first they will try to remove the problem. Imagine that if the problem is that if the phone is not working, if one particular application is not opening, then they will try to repair and they will make it possible. If it is not possible, then they replace the product. And if they cannot replace the product, then a refund of price. If the, see like if you have purchased this mobile phone for 15,000 rupees, then that money will be paid back. Then award of compensation. Like imagine that you purchase, like if a pressure cooker is purchased, and while using the pressure cooker, when somebody died, or some of your like any other things have damaged. So for that, compensation can be given. The money of how much loss that we have faced, that loss can be there. Then removal of deficiency in service. So like if we are taking a service and if there is some deficiency in the service is there, then that deficiency has to be removed. Then the next one, discontinue of unfair restrictive trade practice. If any kind of trade practices are found, like any unfair trade practices are used, then that has to be stopped. They should not do any of these type of activities again. Then stopping the sale of hazardous goods. If any product is found hazardous, like a food product you are purchasing, in that any chemical content is found, some tablets and all are there, okay, in that they are, may have some side effects, like if you are eating a tablet for headache, then or sometimes when you eat a tablet for fever, you will get a headache, you know, so some other problem will be there. Or some people are like some cough syrup and all is there. If you drink cough syrup, then you will sleep for 2 hours, 3 hours, you know. So you feel sleepy because you feel so much tired, like. So such type of things are there. Some cough syrup are used instead of like wine, like, you know. So you drink this one and sleep nicely. Such type of things are there, you know. So you feel like you are drinking some wine, like. So such feeling will be there. So your head is rotating like that. All these problems. Some cough syrup and all is having some kind of. So in that, this like some kind of like a poison type things are there, you know, or sedatives are there. Like mostly the medicine, what it is doing is that it is like the signals, like painkillers and all. So it is said that if you are continuously using painkiller, after that if your hand is cut, then also you may not know that you will not feel the pain. Means what happens? Why do we feel pain now? You see, like if there are signals receiving to our brain. If our brain is not working, then we will not feel any pain. If somebody is beating us also, we will not feel any pain. Okay? We felt this is signals are transferred to our brain, then only we feel pain. But these painkillers, what it is doing is that they make the these signals stop. They will make a breakage between this. They are working on our brain. So if you regularly use these painkillers, it will affect these cells. So once if that cell is damaged, then after that we will become in such a condition that we will not feel any pain at all. Okay. So these are there. If such kind of any products are there, any hazardous products are found, then the government will or this they will say that we cannot sell this. So they will ban the product. Sometimes they will close the company even. Then a payment of a adequate cost. If any additional cost is found, like imagine that if we have purchased this product and because of that we lost some money or any additional cost is there, then that money will be lost. See, like once in Kerala, there one person, he has booked a flight ticket to Dubai and he got a job there in Dubai and he wanted to join there. So he had booked a flight ticket and tomorrow morning he has to join there for the job and today evening he had to go. Today his flight was cancelled. The company had cancelled the flight. And because of that, this person could not reach there for the job and he could not get the job. And this job was very good job. 2 lakh rupees per month salary something was there. Then he filed a case against the company. And at last the company had to pay some 20 lakh rupees as a compensation to this person. Because he lost his job. Company only cancelled the flight. And he filed a case against the company, airline company, that because the company cancelled this one, then he lost his job. So he filed a case against the company and at last the court was, this one was issued and 20 lakh rupees of compensation was given. So such a way, this will be there. If you file a case against it, but normally what happens is that it is our bad luck, so we did not get a job. So we leave it like that. So such a way it will continue. It is not necessary that always you file cases then you will get a 20 lakh rupees compensation. But sometimes this is possible. Okay. Next topic that we have to study is about consumer's rights. So we are having some rights. Some rights are there as well as some responsibilities are there. So under the Consumer Protection Act, we have some rights are there. So this is an important topic you have to study. So this first one is called a right to safety. Okay, a consumer has the right to safety against such goods and services as hazardous to his health, life and property. For example, spurious and substandard drugs, appliances made of low quality raw material such as electric press, pressure cooker, etc. and low quality food products like bread, milk, jam, butter, etc. The consumers have the right to safety against the laws posed by such products. So first our right is that right to safety. So whatever products that we are purchasing or which we are getting should be of they should give safety should be there. Okay, so if we are purchasing sometimes like if iron box and all are there or like a room heater and all is there. See like some kind of products are there which is having like so much amount of side effects are there. Okay, so we are using that product and people will get affected. But what happens is that we purchase this product for very low price. You know, very low quality product will be there. Like normally an iron box will be costing some 1,000 rupees, 5,500 rupees like that. Minimum. Good if you want to have. But in 200 rupees also you will get an iron press. But in that, there is no any guarantee, the wire will get cut in between, then you will get shock from the wire. That wire, the cable, we are connecting, that cable is of a very low quality. So when you are using it very regularly, there is a chance that wire will be opening. So by chance, if you are holding, when you are connected, if you hold it, then you may get shock. Sometimes on the iron box, on the body also, if you touch it, then it will get shocked. So there are some kind of issues like that. So there are some, especially electronic products, whenever we purchase, we should see to it that there is ISI mark on the product. And also we should purchase, whenever we purchase the, especially electronic products, whenever we purchase, we should purchase only good quality ones. You have to see like some good brands are there. And even if you are like some 500 rupees or 600 rupees extra, you may have to pay. But we should purchase only good quality products. If you purchase low quality product, if this good quality branded products, if you purchase and if any kind of issues are found, then at least we can file a case against and we will get benefit. Getting benefit is not that important, but first of all, there will not be much amount of side effects will not be there. Any kind of problems will not be there. But what happens is that we will think only about initial profit, isn't it? So for some time only, this water heater and all is there, isn't it? So like immersion heater which you are using for heating water. So that also is there, some kind of water heater is there and if you put a heater into that and if you touch on the water also, you will get shocked, isn't it? But if you purchase some good quality ones, it will not be there. So it is giving protection against those things. Don't try good quality one at home, you don't say that. There is a chance that this heater will get a shock like that if you put a hand on that. Some are there, see like some products and all are there, see like mobile phone and all when you purchase like like safeties are there, like if it is falling also it will not break like that, you know, gorilla glass or a different type of protection things and all that. But once if it is falling, then whatever gorilla is there, then also it will break. So there are some things like that. So it should be right to safety is there. So it is our right that we should get products and it should not affect our health. Okay, or especially the products that we are eating things, edible things are there. So that should not affect our health anyhow. Okay, some type of products are there. People, those who are regularly eating some products, they get some kind of stomach upset or some other sicknesses. Okay. Then next one, right to be informed or right to representation. A consumer has also the right that he should be provided with all the information on the basis of which he decides to buy goods or services. Such information relate to the quality, purity, potency, standard, date of manufacture, method of use, etc. of a commodity. Thus, a producer is required to provide all such information in a proper manner so the consumer is not cheated. So that is why nowadays it is very made compulsory that on the product all these details are printed. You know, so there should be a label, and on the label there should be all the details mentioned. The name of the company, manufacturer, where it is manufactured, and the date of manufacture, and the price of the product, or name of the company. Every information has to be properly mentioned on the product. And even if it is not mentioned, like a mobile phone or any other type of things when we are purchasing, if the informations are not there, then if you ask to the shopkeeper, then they are ready, they should be giving proper information to us. So we should get a proper information. So that is our responsibility, or it is our right that we have to, whatever questions that we are asking, the shopkeeper should be able to give us answers. So we should get a proper information. That is why mostly the companies are using toll free numbers on the product. So even if the shopkeeper may not know all the information, but if you have any complaints or if you have any information to ask, then you can call to the customer care, then they will give you all the details. You know, mostly like all the trusted brands, they keep their like toll free numbers are printed on the product itself, and if you have any queries or complaints like that, we can call them and understand these things. The next one is a right to choose. A consumer has the absolute right to buy any goods or services of his choice from among the different goods or services available in the market. In other words, no seller can influence his choice in an unfair manner. If any seller does so, it will be deemed as an interference in this right to choose. So right to choice is there, means that we should go to the shop, and the shopkeeper should not compel us to purchase the product. You know, they can motivate us to purchase. They will say that this product is good if you wear it, like if you are going for purchasing a shirt, they say that it is good that you can wear it. They will say good words about the product. But they don't have a power, or they have no right to compel us to purchase the product. They cannot say that you came to the shop, you have to purchase and go. You simply cannot go. Like that you cannot say. If I don't like the product, I should not purchase. There is no any compulsory that I entered in the shop, so something I have to purchase. And normally people, they feel like that. No? If you enter into a shop and ask for price and all, and after leaving it and coming, it's not a good habit. Okay. But if you are not happy, or if you are not satisfied with the quality of the product, then you need not to purchase. You know? So it is not necessary that a shopkeeper, they should not compel us to purchase this product. Or they should not, also normally when you go to the shop, they will suggest that this product is good. They can suggest, they can give us information, but whether to choose that one or not, that is our decision. So, you know, we have to make the decision whether to purchase this particular brand or other brand. Okay. Then, right to be heard. A consumer has the right that his complaint be heard. Under this right, the consumer can file a complaint against all those things which are prejudicial to his interest. First, the rights mentioned above, like right to safety, right to be informed, and right to choose, have relevance only if the consumer has the right to file his complaints against them. So the right to hear, or right to be heard. See, like if, imagine that I purchased a mobile phone from the shop, and when I go to the shop, and if I tell that the product which I have purchased is not working. So when you go, then it is the duty of the shopkeeper to listen what is my complaint. They have to imagine that your parents are coming with the teachers. They will say that they are having some complaints. They are not getting online classes, or sometimes they may make phone call and ask. So it is the right of the people that they need to, like a right to be heard. So they should, if I am a purchase, if I am a consumer, the one, the shopkeeper should, or the company should have the courtesy to listen what our problem is there. You know, so this is not working or this is not having. So in that also, this toll free numbers are there. So in that we can file if like a mobile phone and all, normally like you purchase any, normally we people call and make complaints, you know, for scolding only we may be calling to the customer care. So they will say all the complaints, whatever your problems are there, but they never get angry, you know. So you just call to the customer care and you say all the bad words or anything you speak, but they will never get angry, you know. So they very relaxed way they listen. It is not, they will be saying if you say bad words then they can file complaint, but this is that. See, like imagine if you get angry, you speak very harsh voices if you are speaking, then also they are not getting angry, you know. Very rare cases, very minute cases are there. These customer care executives, they are also human, you know. If they are ill-treated,
when customer
aggressive means there are some situations are there. These people, they irritate in such a way, then only they lose control. But if they get angry, then they can even lose their job. They will be sent out, you know, or the fine will be there. They will have to pay fine if they have behaved like that. And if that they will get warning and all. If in that warning also, if they are not changing, then they will be will be terminated. They will lose the job. If again and again the same type of problems. But normally, if you call any customer care, I have many times I felt whenever we call the customer care. Even if we are getting angry with them, they will very normally they speak and they try to convince us. You know, so they will try to pull us. If we are angry, they will not just they will not speak against us and they will accept it, that this is there. So that is a normal way. So that is there. We have the power. The next way how to study is about the right to seek redressal. So this right provides compensation to the consumers against unfair trade practices of the seller. For instance, if the quantity or quality of the product is not conform to those promised by the seller, the buyer has the right to claim compensation. So right to seek redressal. If any problems are found, then we can submit the product, then they will have to either return the product or find if any problems are there of the product, then they have to remove the problems. The next one, right to consumer education. Consumer education refers to educating the consumer constantly with regard to the rights. In other words, consumer must be aware of the rights they enjoy against the laws they suffer on account of goods and services. So consumer education, so we should get information about the products and what are our rights, all this information we have to understand. So we should get proper information about these things. Then next one is a right to basic needs. The basic needs mean those goods and services which are necessary for a dignified living of people. It includes adequate food, clothing, shelter, energy, sanitation, healthcare, education and transportation. All the consumers have the right to fulfill these basic needs. So we should get a basic needs. So these basic needs, the products of this whichever is there for the basic needs, those type of products should be supplied in a very low rate, you know. So very high price and should not be charged for the such type of products. And if by chance if any cases are there where there is like then the government is using some like public distribution systems and all, like food items and all are there. So you know that ration shop and all is there. So there if a person is not in a situation to go to the shop and purchase the rice or wheat and things like that, then you can go to the ration shop and there like 4 rupees, 5 rupees and all you will get rice, you know. How much is the cost of it, that one, you know? Rice in ration shop?
Yes,
2 rupees. 2 rupees, you know. So normally if you want to purchase a rice from a market, you have to pay 40 rupees. But it may not be the same quality, but some rice at least you will get. For 2 rupees, what quality you can expect, you know? So some at least some quality. Anyhow, they can, if a person, that much poor person is there, then he can boil it and eat. There is no any issue like that. It will be of, it should be, that product also should be edible quality, should be there. So even if it is there, 2 rupees rice is there, it doesn't mean that it is of 2 rupee quality. Actually, government is taking the money. If 20 rupee may be the actual cost of this rice. But 18 rupees expense is taken by government, and they are for a, we are just for a consideration we are paying money. Simply if, simply giving free means everyone will simply take it and they don't use it. So our own contribution is required. So 2 rupees is not the price of the rice. So but at least some products has to be there. Then next is about a right to healthy environment. This right provides the consumer protection against environmental protection so that the quality of life is enhanced. So they should have a proper environment, healthy environment should be there. So environment should be neat and clean and we should have a proper environment. So that is also another important right.